Given the importance of contractors, engineers, and architects in the national development of the country, the seminar was conducted to give stakeholders from the sector an opportunity to discuss how best to factor climate change considerations into all works undertaken, to communicate the importance of adapting to climate change, and to understand and appreciate how such adaptation can be integrated into the whole life cycle of projects.
The intention is not only to highlight the projects, the hard engineering projects like roads and bridges that are being done, but also to inform the entire population as to what is climate change, as to how they can adapt to the phenomenon. As part of this overarching public awareness campaign, we are targeting several sectors. And today, what we are doing is to bring together what we call the artisans, building artisans, those persons involved in construction of buildings, plumbers, electricians, masons, engineers, contractors, because it is critical that they come together to discuss how best to put structures together that could withstand the ravages, the impacts of climate change. Because we are being told that right now what we are facing is what is called 1 in 100 storms, 1 in 100 hurricanes. And the forecast really is that we can expect more of these and they're going to be worse. So by bringing those critical people together, they can now discuss how best to design buildings, how best to construct bridges, and how best to plumb homes and so on, considering, of course, renewable energy as well. So we have over 50, closer to 70 of these people here today who are going to be sharing that information and gathering data one from another to ensure that whatever we're doing, climate change is factored into construction going forward.
The chief architect in the Ministry of Physical Planning made a presentation on green building designs.
Kind of informed the participants there as to, you know, what are the features of green buildings. And a lot of these features are not necessarily new. Some of them are basically techniques that are used in older buildings, the buildings our grandparents lived in. And if you look at what, say for example, the larger hotels are doing, the Hotel Chocolas, the Laderas, the Jade Mountains, they're basically learning from all of these older buildings in terms of how to balance natural environments and say green environments, the use of flowers, the use of plants, rainwater harvesting, the roofing structure, you know how to make them more resilient.
The architect wants contractors to consider and compare vintage structures to what currently exists.
You have lots of, say for example, hurricane clamps that are using several aspects of see your buildings in your ridges, in your beam, and see your rafter connections. But sometimes what happens, contractors, and maybe, you know, we are a little tardy in getting things done, and we forget to put things in place, and you realize that most of the damages in, say, some of the hurricanes in, say, Maria and Irma, a lot of the buildings that did survive was heap of buildings. Most of the buildings with the flatter roofs, most of them went. And, you know, again, I'm saying with the older structures.
The forum was held at the Bay Gardens Beach Resort. For the DBS News World, I am Sharefil Gaillard.